I don't think innovation is a risky thing. I think innovation and doing new things is actually the safest option right now. Not to do something or doing as we have always done it, this will lead us to the fate of individual companies, to Kodak and Nokia. But there is a CEO of a large German insurer, one of the top 10 insurers, and he said, I think 3 years ago in an article, he will never produce an app because he believes in the sales agent. I mean, I believe also in the sales agent, at least at the good ones, and I understand that he has a lot of pressure from a sales organization not to do it and do internal competition. But to be quite honest, this guy is still in office. Do you think he does real innovation? Of course not. Of course now he doesn't wear a tie every day and goes to Berlin and has a startup journey there. But they have a lot of, these are, like I say, fake innovation things. And you need to have people on board level that really, really understand what's going on and that are willing to risk. I see three types of decision makers. The first type is like this guy, the CEO of this insurer, a few years left, just wants to, you know, cash in the last years he has. Then I have younger people that say, okay, I have 20 years to go. It's totally clear to me if we continue this path, I have no chance of ending into a pension in this industry. So they do something, even though maybe they don't like to. And we have senior decision makers, older people that say, oh, I've only 3 or 5 years left. I've done my private share here. It's okay for me. Now I go all in and I want to be remembered as the person that turned this thing around. So yes, we have gatekeepers and they are the crucial part that will be decisive if the company is going to make it or to going to break it. The time of test balloons in the insurance industry is over. Slowly but surely changed the whole organization into a tech-driven, data-driven tech company. That's no alternative.